Elay. Hello.
Someone looks pretty today.
That's quite a strange video. It's going to be my 30 week update, but I'm going to talk about, actually, I probably should make it my, I'm 30 weeks, I was 30 weeks yesterday. I'm probably going to make this my 28 weeks plus update, because beforehand I didn't really have any appointments, nothing really happened, everything was pretty much normal, I didn't have any outrageous symptoms. Caitlin! That's quite a strange video. It's going to be my 30 week update, but I'm going to talk about, actually I probably should make it my, I'm 30 weeks, I was 30 weeks yesterday. I'm probably going to make this my 28 weeks plus update, because beforehand I didn't really have any appointments, nothing really happened, everything was pretty much normal, I didn't have any outrageous symptoms. Caitlin! Caitlin's just knocked the whole blind down just as I was filming. This is the reason that I can't film. This is literally the reason why I struggle so much to find time to film, because stuff like this happens. She's knocked the whole thing off. Seriously, 11 months old. You cheeky, aren't ya? Are you cheeky? You cheeky girl. She looks really like sorrowful now. For my 28 week growth scan, basically it was really quick. I had to go to a different hospital because it was booked at a different hospital and you can only go where it's booked. So I went along to that. I went with my mum, my sister-in-law to be, looked after my daughter. And yeah, basically we just went along to that and we were seen really quick. We didn't have to wait very long. And yeah, they just, it's just a normal scan, abdominal scan. And they measured the baby. The baby's now measuring or weighing 2 pounds 14 ounces, or was 2 weeks ago, he's probably more than that now. But 2 weeks ago he was 2 pounds 14 ounces, which I think is normal. Every baby's different anyway, every baby grows at different rates. But I feel happy with that weight. I don't know what Caitlin was, because I think with Caitlin I had a growth scan at 32 weeks until 39 weeks. Before they induced me, so I don't have anything to compare it with, because I never kept any of my growth scan reports because I had so many with Caitlin because he was measuring big. But this time I'm hoping that he does it, that they don't induce me because just because he's measuring big, because Caitlin was actually a normal weight. She wasn't huge, she wasn't small, but she wasn't huge, she was just in the middle. So yeah, I'm really happy with that. They did all the measurements, everything looked fine. They did the blood flow between the placenta to the baby, which is all normal. I had a doctor scan at 24 weeks to check that as well, and that was normal, which is reassuring. It's really reassuring having these doctor scans to check that the umbilical cord's okay and the placenta's okay. I don't think I had that with Caitlin, I don't remember. I don't know if that's a new thing they're doing this year, but I don't remember having the blood flow checked with Caitlin. It really, not a lot, to be honest, happened. In the way of symptoms, I haven't really noticed anything much different. I've been feeling pretty normal. I haven't been getting any Braxton Hicks. I had really bad ones at 21 weeks, but that was due to eating something that didn't agree with me. And then I had some more, I can't remember what reason. I think it was because I was drinking water, but I was swallowing a lot of air with the water. So when I get wind, I get lots of Braxton Hicks, but I haven't had an issue with that since, and I haven't had any twinges. Well, a little bit of a twinge, obviously. 30 weeks pregnant, you're going to feel something. But it's usually due to the baby's position rather than anything bad. Because he's very, very active. He's moving around all the time, which is really, really reassuring. I'm really enjoying being pregnant and trying to enjoy these last 10 weeks, or less than 10 weeks now, until he's here, trying to look after my exhausting but lovely 11-month-old and getting help as well. But I can't wait till he's here and have two young kids. It's going to be, it's a lot of fun. I mean, I never get bored. I'm always doing something. I'm always thinking of things to do. It's a good way to live. I love doing it. But yeah, so symptom-wise, I don't really have anything to report on. My consultant scan was a week afterwards. That was very quick as well. I didn't have to wait very long. But basically, she just asked how I was. It was just a checkup. She asked how I was and basically asked if there was any problems I was having. The baby looks fine. His weight's fine. He's growing fine. All his measurements are fine. The blood flow is fine. Everything looks great. And I didn't get any pictures or anything because the NHS growth scans, you don't. But I might have, if I have another one in late pregnancy, I might have another one if I don't get any more, if I feel like I want one, then I will obviously get pictures with a private one, but NHS ones you don't really get pictures with, unless it's the 12 and 20 week scans, then you do, and you have to pay for them. Not a lot though, but yeah, so they checked my stomach with the Doppler. Checked his heartbeat, checked his position. I think, yeah, he was head down. He was breech, 28 weeks, I think he was breech, but then he literally switched to head down that day because I had a midwife appointment my 28th week, exactly my 28th week. And then I had the scan after the midwife appointment, during the afternoon. And again, the midwife appointment, it was mainly just measuring the baby, like measuring my stomach with the tape measure. He was measuring a little bit big, but obviously I had the scan and he was measuring perfectly normal. So, and then she said that he was breech, because he was in a bit of an uncomfortable position. His head was up, but then because I walk a lot, I'm always active. I'm not slumped like I was with Caitlin. I was slumped a lot on the sofa because I didn't have much to do. This time I'm always bending forward, I'm always sitting forward, I'm always walking, I'm always picking my baby up, I'm always active, walking. So that's a good sign because it means that the baby will get into a really good position for birth. So I'm trying to keep as forward, sitting forward as I can, and as active as I can without overdoing it. But yeah, that's pretty much all I have to update on. My next midwife appointment is at 34 weeks because with your second baby you don't get seen by the midwife as much as with your first. But then obviously I am getting towards the end. Not the end, but you know, I'm in my third trimester, so once I start from 34 weeks onwards, it'll probably be fortnightly. It'll be like 34 weeks and 36 weeks and 38 weeks and 40 weeks, and then if I go overdue. So yeah, basically, I had my blood test on, which was normal. Yeah, it was all normal. I'm not anemic. I'm taking iron supplements anyway. I'm taking 7C's pregnancy. I was taking pregnant care and now I'm taking 7Cs, and now I'm taking omega-3 capsules, which I did with Caitlin, and I'm taking active iron supplements, which keep my iron levels up, and I have really good energy. Sometimes I feel like I'm lacking in energy, but most of the time it's because, I don't know, I'm hungry or something like that. So that's basically it. I know this is a bit of a rambly video. I'm trying to just get everything I want to say out there before I have to go and rush off and do stuff. So I'll probably update my next scan after my next scan, which is going to be in 2 weeks, less than 2 weeks time. I think it's less than 2 weeks. Yeah, less than 2 weeks time. So 32 weeks. So I'll probably update then, and then I've got another consultant appointment the week after that. I don't know why it can't be the same day, so it would be a lot easier. At 33 weeks, and then I don't know if from then on, I don't know if I'm going to have any more scans or consultant appointments. I might stop at 33 weeks. But I will be seeing my midwife every fortnight, probably, for any concerns or, you know, to check the baby. And I may or may not, if I feel like I need one, have another growth scan at like 36-ish weeks, just because I am paranoid and I like to just get everything like checked thoroughly, because I am quite an anxious person and I get worried about things. So I will see you in my next video. Bye.